gonna cover you. Make a run for the door. You ready?
Go! Go!
The show this year is for season 8 takes place in New York City.
This season's got a lot of storylines going. For Jack Bauer, he's ready to move on with his life. I think he's really ready to take on the life of being a grandfather and spending more time with his daughter.
And just when he thought it was safe,
I'm out. I don't work for the government anymore.
There's a big hit going down.
He gets brought back into things.
President Taylor is getting ready to start a massive peace initiative through a conference that is taking place at the UN with President Hassan. There's obviously a group from the country that does not want this peace to happen, and that's where the day starts to go wrong.
In the world of counterterrorism, there's been a hole, and CTU is now a project, essentially a pilot program that has been reconstituted. And 24, we think, defined kind of that near future, 5 minutes into the future technology, which accounts for some of the kind of futuristic stuff and environment that you're seeing here.
Like many other seasons, I think there's a very good balance between characters that are very familiar to an audience and brand new characters as well.
At the helm is a guy named Brian Hastings, who really advocated this project, who has a lot at stake. And the two people who are running the techno side of things are Dana Walsh, who's played by Katie Sackhoff. It turns out, too, that Dana isn't all she's advertised to be and has a past, which comes back to haunt her. And it's complicated by the fact that she's in love with the guy who's running the CTU ops, Cole Ortiz, who's played by Freddie Prinze Jr. So he's the gun to her computer. Arlo Glass is a drone pilot. So again, we're taking from the headlines and saying, well, what if in an urban counterterrorism situation, the drones that we know and read about in Afghanistan and Pakistan and Iraq were operating here in New York City?
I know that you left the FBI under difficult circumstances.
Difficult doesn't even begin to describe it.
I can get you your badge back.
Jack and Renee became very close during the course of season 7. She was a major factor in his survival. So he has not only an incredible respect and I think affection for her. And that plays out in the development of their relationship through season 8.
People are always talking about reinventing 24, and we understand the rhythms and the surprises and the pulse of the show. And so it is the same 24 that people have come to love, but also it feels like a new show.